My theme in life is to ignore the impossible. I very much like to see, we hear all the time that we tell children, you can do anything you want. And honestly, I don't believe that. There are a lot of things we can't do. I cannot dunk a basketball, okay? I've got no jumping ability whatsoever. But the way I found out about that was by trial and error. Continually trying, continually failing. And failure is an integral part of our lives. We often sometimes see it as something that's very bad. Failure is fantastic. We learn very little from success. If you always succeed, you would think that you always know what you're doing. When the truth is, we often have no idea what we're doing. We learn as we go. I've run 145 marathons now, which is a little bit more than the one that I said I was going to stop at. As I've run those 145 marathons, I've learned the more I run, the more I learn, the less I actually know. I learn just as much from beginning runners as I do the elites and the greats. You know, I'm constantly a sponge. What I've done in life has allowed me the fortuitous opportunity to speak with and hang out with some of the greatest runners that America has ever produced. And by listening to them and learning, I see how humble they are and how non-elitist they are, because they grasp this too. These are people that used to run the fastest times in the world. Now that they're a little bit older, they no longer can do that. And they grasp how fleeting athleticism is, and how lucky you are to be able to do what you do. Often we hear things about how I have to go for a run today, or I have to go for a swim, or I have to do this, or I have to do that. My father, right before I was born, was crippled in a hunting accident. He was unloading a .357 Magnum that went off into his leg and blew away most of his leg. He passed away last year, complications from a different illness. But throughout his life, he never once complained about that leg. And I knew he was in excruciating pain all the time. But he dealt with that pain, and he continued to do things. I came home once from college, and we had a new fountain in our yard that looked like it had been created by nature. Rocks and a water fountain, and all these waterfalls going down. And I said, where did that come from? My dad said, your mom and I built it. I'm like, you and mom did. My mother had rheumatic fever when she was a child. She was bedridden for about 3 years when she was growing up. My mom has had two open heart surgeries and has an aortic valve replacement in her heart now. My mother with a fake heart and my dad with a crippled leg built a waterfall in our front yard. When I hear people complain about the little things that go wrong in their life, I think back to that. I think back to the, I have to go for a run. I have to go for a swim. No, you don't have to. No, you do not. You get to. And it's easy to remember that part about I have to. It's easy to forget that you get to. Earlier this year, I had a staph infection in my foot. I came this close to losing my foot. Not that I needed the reminder, because of what I think, I look at my parents and I look at what they've overcome. But that reminder helped me. You know what? I had some goals this year that had to be pushed away because I lost a lot of training because of this foot. And yeah, I'm sore sometimes. And yeah, I've got to go out there and push through some pain. But I get to do that. I get to put on a pair of shoes and go out there. And that's why it bothers me so much when I see people, including the people that are close to me, that are out of shape from their own choices. Because health and wellness is a choice for most of us. You can choose to exercise. You can choose to eat properly. And the two go hand in hand. People often ask me for what's the magic thing that you eat? I go, there is no magic thing. And for everyone, it's completely different what you eat. We all know what to do. Put down the Cheetos, put down the Doritos, you know. You can have some every once in a while. Believe me, I do, okay? But you should be eating properly. A little bit of meat, a little bit of salad, all those good things. So what you should do is make those right choices to be able to do what you want to do. There's a gentleman named Ed Whitlock. He lives in Canada. In his mid-70s, he ran a 2 hour and 53 minute marathon. That is approximately 6:45 minute miles. mid-70s. I'm sure you all saw about the woman who just swam from Miami to Cuba. Diane Nyad is her name, if I can pronounce it correctly. She was, if I recall, 66 years old. She failed in this attempt to swim from Miami to Cuba 4 times. She finally completed it. And she said, you know what you need to do is always be pushing forward. So if you take anything from me tonight, and I hope it's, again, it's not that I think that I'm so special. In fact, I think I'm just like the rest of you. I just happened to find what I was good at, and I went for it. So I hope if you get anything, is that you should constantly strive forward. You know the secrets to do the things that you want to do. You know the things that you shouldn't do that are stopping you. So go out there, stop doing the things you're not supposed to do. Start doing the things that you will, and you'll succeed. You had a litany of wonderful speakers here telling you about the scientific results of what they've looked at. These are people that have done the things that they wanted to do to get to where they are. I gave up what I was thinking that I wanted to do at one point. I was interviewing to be in the CIA, believe it or not. I decided during the 52 marathons that running was what I wanted to do. Back to that final marathon of those 2006, when I thought, there's nothing I can do to top this. I've learned that I can, but it has nothing to do with me. It's going out there and spreading this message of challenging yourself. What I did that day wasn't all that special. When I finished those 52 marathons, that was fine. But what it opened up for me was the opportunity to be right here. This is the thing that motivates me every day. People say, how do you stay motivated? It's because I get the opportunity to meet and talk with people like yourselves every day. And when I say yourselves, I mean by myself as well. We're the same. Hopefully you've done what you wanted to do in life, but if you haven't, it's never too late. You can always go out there and strive for more. So again, if you take anything from me, I really hope that you just go out there, starting today, and say, you know what? I'm going to ignore the impossible. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.